Come join Aventura here in the beautiful Italian region of Val d'Aosta. We'll hike amongst the highest mountains in Europe. Meet farmers who make the world-famous Fontina cheese. We'll attend a village music festival. And we'll learn to cook a risotto Val d'Aosta style. Wow, what an incredible view, and what a great way to start the morning. Buongiorno, my name is David Rocco, and we're here in the region of Val d'Aosta, and just below me is this picturesque town of Conne. From here, you can see gorgeous mountains in every direction, but I have to remind myself, we're here in Italy, not Switzerland, and there's a reason why everything looks so Swiss. So let's take a look at the map. Val d'Aosta is in northern Italy. It's called the crossroads of Europe, because it shares a border with both France and Switzerland. Val d'Aosta is Italy's smallest region. It's entirely mountainous, so it feels huge. And as for natural beauty, well, let me show you. Let's go for a walk. Val d'Aosta is surrounded by mountains, which provide shelter from harsh winds and give it a mild alpine climate. The mountain people here in Val d'Aosta are very proud of their land and take great care of their environment. Everywhere here in the region, you can go on a gorgeous nature trail. In spring, the alpine meadows dazzle with endless varieties of wildflowers. The fresh growth brings chamois, ibex, and these wild mountain goats called Steinbocks down from the mountaintops to feed. This was once the private hunting ground of the Italian royal family. Today, much of Val d'Aosta is part of Gran Paradiso National Park. The dappled colored cattle are called Pezzata Rossa Valdostana. Grazing on the alpine meadows gives their milk a unique quality for making authentic Fontina cheese. You see that old farmhouse across the alpine meadow? Well, that's where they make Fontina cheese. Let's go pay them a visit. Buongiorno, c'è qualcuno?
Oh, buongiorno.
Ciao Giuseppe,
buongiorno.
Come stai?
Piacere. Bene, bene, prego,
allora?
venga.
Giuseppe has just told me that we're making cheese now, the Fontina cheese, and this is fresh cow's milk that he's waited about 30 minutes for the milk to curdle, and he's just stirring it around. He says we're almost ready now. Posso girare? Get some of my exercise in. Giuseppe is now scooping all the cheese with the cheesecloth, shaking out all the excess milk. Now we're just going to get the cheese and put it in the form.
Seventy liters
of milk, 7 kilos of Fontana cheese. And now he's just draining all the excess milk.
È come la ricotta.
No, non è.
Si può mangiare?
Sì.
Posso provare?
Prendi un pezzettino. Non ha gusto di sale, eh? Senti, è come una gomma, un chewing gum, eh?
Mm. È come un chewing gum.
Esatto.
He just said it's very tasteless right now because he hasn't added the water and salt process.
Ecco.
And this is just to have all the excess milk removed from the form. So now Giuseppe is going to turn over the form. Giuseppe, grazie molto for teaching how to make this fontina cheese. It looks beautiful.
È stato un piacere.
Piacere mio, grazie. Ciao, David.
Ciao.
Come stai?
Bene.
This is Chef David Alero from Lou Rosignano Restaurant. Now, with a name like David, he's got to be a great chef. Allora, stasera cosa facciamo?
Stasera ti preparo la soubette alla cognenza, che è il piatto tipico di Cogne.
Ah.
E sono qua apposta a comprare la fontina per fartela veramente buona.
Bene. Tonight we're going to prepare. He's going to teach us how to make a risotto with fontina cheese. And he says he comes here always to buy the fresh fontina cheese. Perfetto, grazie.
Ok,
ciao. They say the best way to discover the mountains is on horseback. But there's one thing I should let you know. I'm a little nervous because I've never ridden a horse before. And I think this might be a real aventura. So let's go meet this lady who conducts these horseback tours and we'll see what goes on. Ciao, Arianna.
Hi, ciao.
Ciao.
Come stai?
This is Arianna, who conducts these horseback tours. So I'm a little nervous. I want a really calm, gentle, relaxed horse.
But that's
half asleep.
You come from the country where they're all right. We have a lot of teachers
here. Well, I'm
here.
A city folk, so is this my horse?
This is yours. Her name is Tara.
Tara.
She's a poor but Arabian, but she's very calm, and she has brought a lot of tourists around in the mountains.
Wonderful.
So don't worry.
Okay.
Do you want
Tara?
To say hello to her?
Ciao, Tara.
Okay.
Right, so do I need a ladder to hop on?
I hope not.
No?
You look quite lucky.
Give me a...
Yeah, wait.
Okay.
You should put one foot here.
Which one? I don't want to...
Come here this side.
Okay.
Okay, so... Yeah, that's good. Wait, you're already on. Fabulous.
Okay. Tara.
David, sei pronto?
Siamo pronti.
Let's go then.
Okay, andiamo. I don't know. Not bad. So, Arianna, what are these mountains called?
Look, right in front of us, there's Mont Zuc, where we go to ski in the winter.
Ah.
And here you see the big mountains there, that's Gran Paradiso.
Right.
It's a national park.
Right, Gran Paradiso.
Mm-hmm. And then there you see the mountains of Lilla, that's like Arola and all the glass.
So beautiful up here. Come on.
Just squeeze.
Squeeze? I'm squeezing.
No, you're not.
No?
Squeeze all the time. Yeah, look. It
My legs are not strong. Okay.
You don't have to move. Just squeeze.
Right. Okay. Well, thank you very much for the wonderful tour. And now that I'm an expert squeezer, horseback rider, maybe we should go back to the stables.
Okay?
Yeah, thank you very much.
You too. Thank
okay.
you.
Squeeze. It's like... Oh, piece of cake. Boy, that was a lot of fun. A little sore, but a lot of fun. Now, here's something I really know how to ride. A car. So let's head down into Cogne and go discover the old city. We're in the old part of Cogne. Cogne used to be an old mining town till about 30 years ago. Now its main industry is tourism. In the winter months, alpine and cross-country skiing reign supreme. And in the summertime, hikers use it as the main gateway to the Gran Paradiso National Park, one of Italy's most beautiful parks. Fresh water down from the glaciers. Now, that's my idea of city water. You can see the Swiss influence in the chalet-style buildings of Cogne. But the people live an Italian lifestyle. That's why you don't see anyone on the streets. They're taking the typical Italian midday break. The town is proud about keeping heritage buildings intact. For example, all buildings must have roofs made of slate. From the 1200s onward, the Bishop of Aosta governed the Konya Valley for 7 centuries. This church dates back to 1524 and was dedicated to Santa Margarita in Sonvilla. It was later rebuilt in 1869 and dedicated to Sant'Antonio with the exterior frescoes painted in his honor. The people of Valdosta are known for their food and hospitality. Well, here we are at Lou Rossignol restaurant, where they're famous for their local dishes. And I think Chef David's been waiting for us in his kitchen with his Fontina cheese. Let's go see what's cooking. Ciao, David.
Hey,
come
ciao.
Stai?
Bene.
I've been thinking of risotto all day.
Sì, abbiamo qua gli ingredienti per fare la suppetta.
Okay, so we have all the ingredients.
Abbiamo il brodo di manzo.
Okay, this is the beef broth, which is very important in a risotto.
Sì, abbiamo il burro.
Butter.
Riso, che può essere benissimo riso arborio.
This is arborio rice, that's the Italian sticky rice.
Vino bianco della Valle d'Aosta.
Ah, I love white cooking wine.
E la cannella in polvere.
Strano. Cinnamon?
La cannella ne metteremo solo un pizzico alla fine del piatto.
This is used just at the end as a dressing.
Vedrai dopo.
Aiuto. Ok.
Adesso prepariamo l'ultimo ingrediente. Abbiamo i crostini di pane, che me li taglierai tu.
Ok, now we have the last few ingredients, which is the fontina cheese and whole wheat bread.
Okay.
And I think he wants me to start working.
Taglia i crostini.
Ok, so I'm going to cut this whole wheat bread into thin slices, which is called crostinis. Quanto fetti?
Sì, 4 o 5.
So 4 or 5 slices.
Ok,
very
molto
thin.
Bene.
Ok.
Abbiamo qua un po' di burro.
So the next process is to get the bread and put it in the butter frying pan, which has been melted, and just saute
it. Giù,
va bene?
Benissimo.
Okay. Per quanto tempo?
Sì, un attimino.
So basta not very long, just until the bread gets golden brown.
Sì, imburrano così.
Ah.
Bello.
Ok.
Benissimo, appena fanno un po' di crosticina.
Ok. Perfetto.
Adesso gli ingredienti ce li abbiamo tutti.
Tutto fatto.
Ti lascio andare e ci vediamo qui dopo.
Great, very easy. We have all the ingredients for risotto and I'm going to get going and I'm going to return later on tonight to make the risotto. Grazie.
Okay.
Ciao.
Ciao.
These laneways take you through the old part of town where wood carvers and lace makers are still working like they did 2 centuries ago. And I hear they're having a party, so we should go check it out. It'll probably be a lot of fun. A Valdostan party is called a viela. It's like an Italian version of the North American barn dance. In the old days, people would gather in a stable to fill the long winter evenings with music and crafts. Today, the traditions continue. Their craftsmanship is highly regarded and sought after by collectors. This lacework is called dentelier and is said to originate with nuns in France. The men of Valdosta are known for their extraordinary skill as wood sculptors. They carve the stories, myths, and legends of ancient times. This technique of playing the tambourine is typically Valdosta. And no, it's not painful on the fingers. We're off through the mountains to the town of Amnaville to see a beautiful old castle and to hear incredible music. We're traveling north through the mountains to the town of Amnaville. Il Castello di Amnaville was built in the 18th century. This is a good example of the type of castles you'll find here throughout Valdosta. people here are proud of their northern Italian heritage, and this is one way they keep the traditions alive. Amneville is also famous for its annual choral festival. This is where each town sends its best choir to compete. And this is when the castle comes alive with the sound of music. Bravi, bravi! Elisabetta, that was great!
Thank you!
This is my friend Elisabetta from Cone, who is part of the Cone choir.
Yeah, so we, you know, we need somebody to join our choir.
To join your choir?
Yeah.
Oh, there's lots of people.
Don't you mind to help us?
Me, no, I don't have a very good voice.
Come on, we just need a little audition.
I don't even know the words.
Oh, it's easy, I'm sure you can make it. The song we made.
Okay, it's just Carmen, right?
Right,
okay,
Carmen!
Okay, sure, how hard could it be?
Carmen.
I'm not Italian.
Too bad with the song.
Oh, well.
Maybe you can try with a dance.
A dance? Sure, you and I?
Why not?
Okay.
Let's go.
I'm not a very good dancer, though.
Let's try.
My dancing's like my singing.
Okay, we'll see.
Okay. What's this? Excuse me. What's this? Jose. These people in Valdosta are great. The guy couldn't find a woman, but he finds a wine barrel to dance with. Say forte. The Cone Choir always has the honor of singing the last song here at the festival. In fact, they're amazing. Speaking of Cone, though, we should get back to see how Chef David at Lou Rosignol is doing. I mean, he might need my help in giving him a hand. Ciao, David.
Ciao.
I see you've already started.
Ho già cominciato a fare il risotto.
Okay, this is a very simple process. I'll explain it to you. What David's done, he's gotten some butter and he's melted it inside this pot. Then he's gotten the arborio rice and he's put it in after the butter's been melted. And he's just stirring right now so it doesn't stick to the pot.
Okay, se mi passa il vino bianco.
Okay, a little bit of white wine, posso?
Prego.
Okay.
Okay.
You gotta keep stirring so the rice does not stick.
Quando il vino bianco si è asciugato.
So the rice is supposed to absorb all the liquids.
Si mette il brodo.
Okay. Once the rice has absorbed the liquids, you put some beef broth. And you continue stirring. This is a very labor-intensive process, so you can't leave the stove.
Si continua a girare.
Okay. Bene.
E quando manca, si aggiunge un po' di brodo.
Okay. He just repeated, when the broth has been all absorbed, add more broth.
Sì, ci vogliono 20 minuti per la cottura.
Perfetto.
Noi, per comodità, l'abbiamo già preparato.
Okay, David's been kind enough to already prepare the cooked rice for us.
Abbiamo già un po' di pronto.
Okay. Hai bisogno di questo?
Ho bisogno della cocotte. Okay. Molto bene.
This is just a oven-safe casserole that David's already preheated. And this is the cooked rice.
Si fa uno strato di riso.
So you put the rice inside the casserole.
Mi passi i crostini.
My favorite, crostini.
4 o 5.
Okay, these are the sautéed crostini with butter.
Quelli che hai fatto tu.
Thank you. David's giving me some credit now.
Okay.
And you just layer them.
Molto bene. Okay. E adesso copriamo con la fontina.
And this is the thinly sliced fontina cheese.
Sì, mettiamo un po' di fette di fontina.
Okay.
Così.
And you just cover the whole dish.
Va bene.
Perfect.
Adesso viene il segreto.
Ah, now his secret.
Il segreto che ti avevo parlato, una spruzzata di cannella.
A little bit of cinnamon on top.
Ok. Poi avevamo preparato del burro noisette. Okay.
So this is melted butter now.
Del burro noisette.
Ok.
Bello caldo, lo si mette
nice
sopra.
Nice and hot, and Dave is just sprinkling it on the cheese, the fontina cheese.
E si mette sopra, con un cucchiaione.
Perfect. Now, we only did one layer. You can do several layers, but I know David's cooked a lot for me, so we'll stop at one layer. It's kind of like a cake.
Okay, il piatto è pronto.
It's done.
Perfect. Puoi sederti a tavola.
That was easy. And David said, now I can go into the restaurant, and he'll be out to bring it to me.
Grazie. Okay.
Ciao, buonasera a tutti.
Ciao.
Ciao, Elisabetta.
Hi, David.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good to see you again. Good. I can't wait. I'm having risotto tonight.
Wow.
Wait, ciao, David.
Ciao.
Come stai?
Allora, il tuo vino.
Perfect. And it's from Valdosta, vero?
Sì.
Perfect.
Si chiama Torretta. E qua c'è la tua soupette.
Mmm. Posso provare?
Sì, certo.
Mmm, it looks really good. Nice and cheesy. Mmm. Buonissimo. You have to try some. This risotto is so good and it's so easy to make. It's risotto with fontina cheese. And here's the recipe. Excellent. Cooking the risotto takes about 20 minutes. Although it's easy to make, it's labor intensive. And remember, only add a little beef broth to the risotto. Once the broth evaporates, you must add a little more and keep stirring. This gives the risotto a rich and creamy consistency. Here in Valdosta, I had so much fun, and I have so many fond memories to take home with me, from beautiful mountains and trails to such warm and kind friends. I even learned how to ride a horse. Ouch. And as for my singing, well, actually, we shouldn't even go down that road. Thank you, and join us again on Aventura.
Carmen.